Nana, Dr. Michael Ejikum Ado. I was born in Sushai, a village near Koforidua, specifically on 3rd of January 1950. At six, I could see my suits. Everything was all right. My mom was a trader. So I would say that I was one of the pampered children at Sushai. At seven, I could hear my mom wailing. She was sick. And the family took her to the hospital. She comes back. The next 2 days, she starts moaning again. They take her back to the hospital. It went on and on and on. For 15 years, my mom was in bed. They sold all her properties to look after her. That was when I was seven. So I took over the grocery business of my mom at the village market, Sushai, crediting everything at Jumapo on market days, on Fridays. I had to go and assemble all these things at the market before I go to school. From 7 to 22 was too much struggle for me. And from class 1 all the way to class 6, I used only 2 uniforms, which means I didn't have the means to buy the uniform. My mom couldn't and my father wouldn't. Then my head teacher at the middle school went to tell the then MP, Member of Parliament of New Jwabing. It was in the name of Mr. M.O. Okwetia. He took me to Ghana Secondary School, got admission letter, got the prospectus for me, and gave my father a job as brigade camp commandant. So he assumed that my father would take over from there. So I went to my dad, showed him the admission letter and the prospectus. He said it wasn't his passion, it was not his interest to look after any of his children. We were 28, so he couldn't afford to take us. So I went to Ghana Senior High School, no chopbox, no suitcase, no mattress, no cutlery set. My father went to the headmaster and collected a chit that I should go to house four. The headmaster didn't see how I came. I was in cloth, collar, with no sandals, no chalawete, nothing. So my father dropped me at house four and left. I stood on my legs from 3 o'clock in the afternoon that he left me till 8:30 in the night. Standing and watching these students come and go. The taxi will come and then they will pull out suitcase, chopbox. Then the carrier used to carry it to the dormitory. And I was watching them. At 6 o'clock, all of them trooped to the dining hall. I could hear that they were learning new songs, Homo songs. 8:30, they came back. Then a senior on duty asked me, "What are you looking for here? All the carriers are gone." I said, "I'm not a carrier. I came to school." And he inquired, "What shows that you came to school?" Then I showed him the cheat. That confirmed that I've been admitted. He said, "Ah, this is not the way we go to school. Boarding house for that matter. Where are your things? Your suitcase, your troubles? I don't have anything." So he took me upstairs. I messed up with the students. He put on the light, ordered all the students to get up from their beds and watch this foolish boy who has come to school in cloth. So all of you hoot at him. So they all hooted at me. It was through the hooting that one of the students identified me. So when the lights were off, he came to my bedside because I was sitting on the bed. It's metal, so there was no way I could sleep because I didn't have the mattress. "Ado, I know you. I come from the next village, Jumapo. Anytime you came to buy the stuff, I could see you. I am Charles Osubwati. Come to my bedside and give me one each of the prospectors." pant, singlet, sandals, shirt, and the shorts. So the next morning, I became Oga. I had everything that all the other students had, so I could mix nicely. 2 weeks later, all the seniors came, and we had kit inspection. So Charles collected all his stuff, said after the kit inspection, he'd give them back to me. So when the master got to my turn, said, ah, is that the way he came? Then the senior on duty said, yes, that's the way he came, in cloth. My friend, we don't do it that way. You better go home. He made sure that I went home. So I went back to Ghana Secondary School. I had to copy notes to catch up. But interesting thing is that the first time I entered the classroom was French. The teacher entered and announced, "Asseyez-vous." I couldn't understand. "Conjuguez, portez." So you know, didn't see me. My share, my students, you know, my mates, you know, and him, would be sorry. No, I'm Frasier. Jimmy Portobia. Tite Portobia, Elsie Portobia, Elsie Portobia. No, no, Portobia, no, my tremendous, I should have my cemetery. Ah, in the Greek, and Nancy, the French, the mean Tiffy. So 1.5 terms, you know, I share Guamante. So am I going to cope with it? I said, panicking. But with determination, I made it. I copied notes. Form 2, first term, said school fees. So they drove us away. Anytime we were in the class, the master would come. The following students, if they are here, they should walk out. They owe the school fees. Adomaiko. Go to the dining hall. The following, if they are here, they should walk out. Adomaiko. At a point in time, the dining hall prefer to order that they should pour water on all the food that is left. And I could see myself picking yam and rice from the water, which we call soplos. I was eating soplos. In the dormitory too, the master would pour water on my mattress. This time I had mattress because I'm in Form 2 now. So I could not sleep on the mattress because I owed school fees. So I would stay in the bush. Ghana Secondary School, there was a bush by the school. Till 10:30 p.m., when I see the lights off, then I walk. After the 3rd week, the teachers, recognizing that I'm still there without paying my school fees, would drag me to the headmaster. And I remember vividly how I would kneel down in front of the headmaster and beg and cry that I want to finish school. I don't want to go home. He had sympathy for me and managed to tolerate me until Form 5. So I realized that my school fees was on credit. When I finished Form 5, interestingly, I passed and passed well. So I could go to the sixth form. So I went to the headman and said, no, you owe us. So not until you clear your arrears, you can be admitted to the lower six. So I went for an interview to be a pupil teacher at Nankese. I taught for 6 months. Okay. Came to pay my school fees, the arrears, before I started the lower six. My plight had not stopped. First day of introduction in the class, we were 35 students. Self-introduction. You get up, you mention your name, the school, and the town that you are coming from. I am so and so from Wesley Girls. I come from Cape Coast. Boache, Prempe College. I come from Bekwai. When it got to my turn, I said, Michael from Sushen, Ghana Secondary School. Then the lecturer said, ah, Ghana Secondary School, is that the Tamale one? I said, no, please go for it there. It was an unknown school. Michael doesn't ring any bell in the family. Then he asked me, where is Sushen? I said, please, it's not on the map. He looked at my face and told me, you can never be a pharmacist. So this lecturer apparently had decided my fate that you can't be a pharmacist. He went on further to say, how did you get admission to this prestigious university to read this noble profession in pharmacy? Every time we did that exam in the subject pharmaceutics, we do everything to fail me. I compare my answer sheets to that of my mates, about the same. Some will get 70, you give me 20. But other subjects, I had B plus, I had A's left and right. And I'm proud to tell the whole world that the whole university were doing statistics the same. Medical school students, engineering, agric, pharmacy, we were all doing the same subject statistics and we're doing the same exams. And I'm always on top. The best in statistics. How come that CVTs alone I should fail? Second year, still D. Third year, results have been pasted on the notice board. And again, it was D. 2 weeks later, it was announced that there had been mistakes in that resource that had been pasted on the notice board. So I know that before me and after me, it has never ever happened that results will be posted on KNUST notice board and to be removed just because there had been a mistake. It never happens. But at that time, it happened. And when the results came back, it was only me that was affected, the whole faculty. And this time around, pharmaceuticals, instead of D, has been changed to F. So I went to the lecturer and said, what happened? He said, I've told you that you can't be a pharmacist. I resat, and of course, he failed me again. So I had to repeat. And it was a nightmare to me. Should I stop or should I continue? The answer came. I should continue. If I continue, this man will still mess me up. So what do I do? Well, what's on it? The rules changed. So BI exams, you know, lecturers, you know, pharmaceuticals, you know, four of them, you know, BI people said 2 questions. Answer 3. Two really, 2. No lecturer, no dean was here. 2. No lecturer, no dean was here. So 4. You have to answer 3. That's 5 questions out of the 8. So really, 2nd, 3rd. Who 3rd? No, who's any dean? Oh, make I pa. So me depend. Extra question. Sa. Any papa any dean? Me try. 5 minutes. Now to say me go shoot them. Me pesa me who dean? Nkuran me who? The question sa obusa oh. And I'm saying for me the past CEO. She say me a pharmacist. I'm a fellow of the Pharmaceutical Society of Ghana. Fellow of the West African Postgraduate College of Pharmacists. I've written books. I've been the president of Ghana Pharmaceutical Manufacturers Association for 6 years. I can pharmacy dear. My company, Kama Health Services, is a household name. It's a force to reckon with. I'm into manufacturing, I'm into wholesaling, retailing, name it. I was representing 8 companies from 12 different countries. Eventually, I got a license to manufacture Tresorix, the popular Tresorix black tonic. The pharmacists are many, you know, and they are in. Your determination, God on your side. Nobody can determine your future. Your destiny is in your own hands. And for now, my company is a member of the Ghana Club 100 since 2001. And I'm proud to tell the whole world that I've gone into a merger with Aspen Pharmaceutical from South Africa. They are the biggest pharmaceutical company in the whole of Africa. They are into 150 countries. So my products are now in 150 countries. Bigger and better than any other pharmaceutical company in Ghana. The destiny is in your own hands.